God who welcomes us all welcomes you here especially. We'll just go ahead and say this is one of the strangest Advent seasons we have ever had, but we are hoping that we can offer signs and witnesses in the space towards discipleship and mission with our service. I'll be sending out announcements in the mail this week, including the prayer requests. If I did not get to you this morning and you have an urgent prayer request, please see me after worship. Again, I will send those out via email and mail if I do not have your email address. Two quick things to let you know of, as an immediate thing. First, youth group will be meeting here at 4:30 today. We'll be going to Christmas at Newberry to walk around and to sort of see the festivities and maybe also get some ice cream. And now, more urgently, the announcement which you have all been waiting for, the nativity scene is going to be put up today in front of the parsonage. We will be meeting at 2 o'clock to put it up. We have already gotten a couple of hay bales. We are anxiously awaiting to put up the manger scene. If you are available at 2 o'clock today and you're able to lift things or put things into the ground, we would love for your help. So please, again, meet at the parsonage at 2 o'clock today to help with the nativity scene. All hands are welcome for this process. Without further ado, let us begin our worship together. As always, we have our Hanging of the Greens service. And right now, I want to turn it over to our narrator, who will bring us in this morning.
Good morning. Each year, about this time, we hear people say, I haven't got the Christmas spirit yet, or I just can't seem to get the Christmas spirit this year. It takes a while some years, longer than others, but eventually, as we hear the carols on radio and department store intercoms and see the tinsel trees and counters bulging with gift suggestions, we begin to recapture the feeling of Christmases past and the spirit returns. As Christians, we look for something more in Christmas than these material and tangible offerings, something deeper. A touch back to the original event, a spirit of hope from God's own heart. Walking through Christmas on Main Street, we miss the hope of the season, the promise of a precious Savior Son who would become the Lord, the Lamb of God, sent to take away the sins of the world. This hope is the core of the Christmas spirit for us who believe.
It is this deeper spirit, this echo of worship from earlier Christmases, that we see this day as we hang the greens. We will welcome back some old friends, the Advent candles, the evergreen garlands, the Christmas tree, the carols, and certainly the familiar Bible stories and passages. And today we will introduce, as new friends, white doves to symbolize the true spirit of the season. Over generations, Christians have associated the white dove with God's own Holy Spirit. It was by that spirit that the Word became flesh and was born of the Virgin Mary. It was through this spirit that our hope turned to realization and joy. Listen again to that story today.
Our first scripture reading comes from Luke, the first chapter, the 26 to the 38 verses. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great servant and would be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestors, David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her, who is said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her.
Because this is a strange Advent season, we are not singing anything, but we do invite you to sing in your hearts or hum along as you wish. We are sticking mostly to hymns that we know, but we are sharing the words on the screen. So for our first congregational hymn this morning, I invite you to sing along in your heart or hum along as you wish, an oldie but a goodie, "Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing." Continuing on with our service, I invite the narrator to come forward to share with us the spirit of life and the hanging of the evergreens.
Okay. life to our room, which calls us to mind the life God gives us through the Savior Jesus. With that life they bring beauty, fragrance, and joy. And that truly is what Jesus brings to us, his life, when we invite him into our lives. As a reminder that life comes by the Spirit of God, we will add white doves to our garlands this year. Hear again the words of life now.
We are ready.
Thank you.
fresh touch this year is found in the delicate white poinsettia plants, which have been dressed for this occasion. What is the color of peace? The absence of conflict and challenge. We have chosen white this year to carry out our theme, the spirit of Christmas.
Just as Jesus is our life and Jesus is our hope, so also Jesus is our peace. He made peace between us and God when we were far away and alienated. And he continues to make peace between factions of humankind trying to share this planet space. Here again the words from the Apostle Paul.
Ephesians 2:14-18. For he is our peace in his flesh. He has made both groups into one and has broken down the dividing wall, that is the hostility between us. He has abolished the law with his commandments and ordinance, that he might create in himself one new humanity in place of the two, thus making peace, and might reconcile both groups to God in one body through the cross, thus putting to death his hostility through it. So he came and proclaimed peace to you who were far off, and peace to those who were near. For that through him both of us have the access, says, in one spirit to the Father.
Let us now listen to the next hymn, Lo, How a Rose Ere Blue. One of our chrismon symbols happens to be an evergreen. Another is a star. You can see that right here. a star, a light, if you will, to show us the way to Jesus. And stars remind us of that starry night in Bethlehem when baby Jesus came, and of the special star that God brought into the sky to show the wise men the way to baby Jesus. Another is the dove, which we're talking a lot about today, and which you can see on all of the wreaths around us. The dove, of course, being one of the oldest symbols of God's Holy Spirit, was the dove that came to earth many times when God wanted his people to know that he was among them. And let's think again of the prayer of Jesus for his church and the admonition of Paul to the Ephesians. Will our next scripture reader come forward?
John 17:20-23. I ask not only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one as we are one. I in them and you in me, that they may become completely one, so that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Also Ephesians 4:2-6. With all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in all.
Now, children, moms, and dads, we have laid out the decorations for the Christmas tree on the front pew. Let the children come. Mom and dads want to come and help the little ones. And be sure to put some decorations high up on the branches. Thank you. gift of family and of friends, the joy of giving, the fun of gathering safely wherever and whenever we can. And we count our blessings as we look for those who have unusual needs and try to make their season happier also. Joy and celebration are deeper for Christians than for others observing this holiday, because the spirit of the season is confirmed by the Spirit of God who lives with us. While others celebrate through the events and trappings, we celebrate with an inner joy that comes from Jesus himself.
Our next scripture reading comes from the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 28 through 32. Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all peoples, a light for revelation to the Gentiles, and for glory to your people Israel."
As we join together in a wonderful carol of celebration, whether singing in our hearts or humming along to the music, our banner bearer will bring our Christmas banner and hang it up for us.
The room is almost ready, and it's time now to read the true story of Christmas from the Bible to our children. The children won't come forward for the reading. We ask them to come. Carly, you bring the candles. Colt, you gonna come down? If you would like, please come down and stand on either side of us as we read by your light.
The birth of Jesus in Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 20. Hear now the good news. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This is the first registration that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you that you will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and laying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what they had been told them about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told to them. My friends, this is the word of God for all people. Thanks be to God. You may return to your seat. Finish our service this morning by singing in our hearts or humming along as we wish three verses to "Come All Ye Faithful." Let us continue. Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.